Welcome to this video. Today we shall have a look at signs, birds and their beaks, class 3 pattern. Signs, birds and their beaks, class 3 pattern. In this picture, you can see a different types of beaks for different birds. So some are clawed, some are chisel shaped, some are broad, some are flat, some are long, some are sharp, some are colored. So you find different types of beaks. The birds have different types of beaks depending upon the food they eat. The penguin, this beak helps them to pick out the small water animals from the snow. Woodpecker, this beak helps it to cut the bark of the tree. Kingfisher, to catch the fish, this is helpful. This long beak will be helpful in pulling out the or sucking the nectar from the flowers. So for example, sparrow, it will help in breaking the nuts. So this is a peacock. So if it is a flesh-eating bird, then the beaks will be so structured that it can tear the food. So different beaks are there with a different shape, different size, different structure for helping their food habits. These are the beaks. Beaks are the mouth of the birds. Birds have no teeth to break the food. Beaks are the mouth of the birds. Birds have no teeth to break the food. Beak helps to catch and break and eat the food. Beaks helps to catch, break and eat the food. Different types and different size and different shapes as per food habits. Different types, size and shapes as per food habits. Beak also help to protect from enemies. So you can see they will use the beak to pick at the other birds to protect the young ones. Strong, short and hard beak. Strong, short and hard beak. This is very short, this is very strong and this is very hard. Why they are hard and why they are strong? Because they eat nuts and seeds. Sparrow, pigeons, peacock and robins. Sparrow, pigeons, peacock and robins have short, strong and hard beaks because they eat nuts and seeds. This strong beak helps to crush the hard nuts and grains. Crack and crush the hard nuts and grains. Strong, short and hard help to crush the hard nuts and grains for pigeons, peacock and robins. Sharp, strong and hooked beak. So this is the hooked beak. This is a hooked beak. The hooked beak are in vultures and eagles and owls. They are the birds of prey. They eat smaller birds and animals. They tear the flesh of the prey. Strong, sharp and hooked teeth are there to help tear the flesh of the prey in flesh-eating birds, in birds of prey. Example, vultures, eagles and owls. So, an eagle can tear off the skin of a rat because it is hooked and because it is strong. Sharp, chisel-shaped beaks. So, these chisel-shaped beaks in woodpecker is helpful to make holes in the tree trunk. The chisel-shaped beaks are helpful to make holes in the tree trunk. It also helps to pull out the insects and worms. Example is woodpecker or hoopoe. Sharp and chisel-shaped beak help to make holes in the tree trunk and pull out insects and worms. Example, woodpecker. Long and pointed beaks. Long and pointed beaks. You can see long and pointed beaks in hummingbird or sunbird. They help to suck the nectar from the flowers. They help to suck the nectar from the flowers. Long and pointed beak help to suck the nectar from the flowers in hummingbird and sunbird. Broad and flat feet. Broad and flat feet. These are there in crane, goose and duck. These are found in waterfowls. Ducks and geese are the example. Holes at the side will be there. So when they take in the muddy water, through the holes, the muddy water comes outside, straining the worms and insects inside. So the broad and flat feet has holes on the side. This is the hole that you can see. Through the hole, the muddy water comes out and strains out. And what remains is the worms and insects, which are eaten by the ducks and goose in waterfowls. Broad and flat feet. Then we have a broad and soft beak. Broad and soft beak are found in swallows. Swallows fly with the open beaks. They catch the insects from the air. The insects stick inside the mouth. So they have a broad and soft beak, which when they fly with open in the air, the insects are caught and it stick inside the mouth. So in the next session, we can study about the claws. Thanks for watching this video. And if you like, please subscribe for more such videos.